Designing a YouTube channel banner is super important to attracting subscribers, but not only just regular subscribers, the right subscribers, the ones that you want your business to be exposed to so that they can take action to do what? Hop into your sales funnels. Having a well-optimized YouTube channel banner is one of the main contributors to having people not only subscribe to my channel every day, but also join my sales funnels. So they are opting into my email list and joining my sales funnels, and I want that to happen for you. If you're new here, my name is Jamar Diggs, and I help consultants and service providers turn their YouTube views into leads and clients. In this very, very quick tutorial, I'm gonna go ahead and share my screen to show you how to make a high converting YouTube channel banner. So let's go ahead and hop into my screen and let's get started. Now, before we get into the aspects of designing a YouTube channel banner, I first want to give you the tips on what to include in your banner and why it is so important for business owners to actually like follow these instructions. First thing that you want to do is add in a photo of you somewhere on the channel banner, and your power statement. Really, the power statement is the most important. And so when we're thinking about the power statement, this is going to be the easiest way for someone to know what your channel is going to be all about. Mine is helping industry leading brands and seasoned experts attract and retain customers with YouTube. Okay, that is very clear. It's very clear on what they should be expecting in every single video. Okay, like there are sometimes the main mistake that I see business owners make is that they just say like something like Pinterest and marketing expert, right? And what they mess up at is, cool, there's so many Pinterest and marketing experts, and you may specialize in a different type of niche or how you help people, right? The strategies may be a little bit different. And so I like to be as specific as possible to where I want someone to either say, oh yeah, this is for me, or no, this is not for me. Okay, so the power statement is the most important part here. And so I like to include your power statement here, maybe a picture of you, and then you can add in some images of some sort. Now, what I used to have here is a little mock-up of my quick start guide. And what this used to say is like, grab your quick start guide, etc. And there was like an arrow pointing down to right here, because that's where those links used to be. But I have seen my clients still have success by still adding their little mock-up here of like their main call to action, and just have there be an arrow pointing a little bit more this way than this way, okay? So that way you have your power statement, a photo of you, which is optional, and your call to action. What is like your main call to action that you want someone to take after they read your banner? And the guests, obviously we want them to subscribe, but even more, we want them to click the link in our description. And we want to tell them, what is that thing? Okay, and you also see I have that as my first link here too, okay? That's kind of like the specifics of what you need to include in the channel banner. Now we're going to go in and start poking through Canva to design one. Okay, now before I get started on that too, I wanna make sure that everything that I'm gonna talk about is inside my YouTube channel quick start guide that is gonna give you everything that you need to launch this channel. Okay, so there's a walkthrough on how to create the channel, and there's also information on how to create your channel banner. So we're gonna walk through these things today. It includes a tutorial, and it also includes the channel banner size guide that you're going to need to make sure that all of the dimensions are correct, because when it comes to this thing here, it's actually a bigger design that you're making, because YouTube wants it to be seen on TV, tablet, mobile, and your desktop, and so they look a little bit different. So go ahead and grab this guide. It's in the video description. Totally free. Grab it. There's also a template to make a keyword rich channel description too. So if you need help on figuring out what to put inside this section right here to make sure that your channel is optimized. I have a template in there for that too. So it's a really, really great free resource for you. Now, when it comes to the actual design, one thing that we have inside our YouTube program is that we have a few templated banners here. And I'm gonna show you how to make something like this, okay? And so we're gonna go into one of our templates and we're gonna choose this one. So what you're gonna do is you're gonna take this design size guide and you're gonna upload it to Canva, and then you're gonna add it onto your graphic here. And there's other ways for you to reach like this stage here. So you can go to create a new design and you should find YouTube channel banner. YouTube banner. And so that will give you the sizes along with a lot of other templates for YouTube videos too. So you have all these other templates for YouTube channel banners actually that are totally free. So you don't even need to worry about the template library that I just showed you. You could use these ones, right? They're not all designed for the size guide. So you're going to have to still move some things around, but you could literally just choose one and then we can start adding in the size guide off of that. So let me show you that too. And here's the size guide. And then you literally just add it here, add it over it, and then go ahead and change the transparency so you can kind of see where everything is. And but you see how this is the view for the TV. This is where the desktop max is. Okay. This is where the desktop minimum and mobile is. So you want to make sure that everything's inside here. Basically everything should be at least inside of this little section here. Otherwise it's not going to show, it's not promised to show. So you want to make sure that you're using this size guide to really, really see where things are. So now let's go back over to my template because I love this template here. Okay. This is probably like the worst picture of me, but it's okay. And so let's just say that we want to add in this picture of me. Well, we need to use the background remover to make it just like kind of just this single thing without that whole background stuff. So we're gonna press that and here we go. We have a nice little thing here and I'm gonna probably flip it horizontal. And this is where I could probably make it a little bit more smaller so that it will fit in there. And see how we're all designing to fit within that section here. And so if you reduce the transparency, you'll see how everything is gonna flow. This down here is gonna be cut off. You won't see it on desktop, but you will see this part right here, okay? And so then we already know that we're gonna enter in a power statement right here. If you want me to do another video all about how to write like the power statements, like let me know. You don't really need to have a name here. I really like it to just be the power statement. And then maybe we'll add in the guide. Then we have this one over here. Okay, so I wanna make sure that this is moved over here, that it's on this side, okay? Or we could move it to where it's right here. You just have to see how you want things to look. So you see how we have this one right here. What you could do is put it right here, then maybe add in some text or an arrow, something like grab the guide. And then you can add a little arrow as a element, excuse me. What I like to do is just kind of like look a little bit, download it and upload it and just kind of see where things go. And so I'm gonna show you that as well. We have this very, very basic thing. We can use some of this space too if we wanna fill it, okay? And maybe I wanna fill it with like my logo. Let's just kind of see. So now I just uploaded my logo and I'm gonna add it here. We're just gonna add it to this part of the design. And then again, we're gonna just kind of look and see. It's just a lot of going back and forth to make sure that everything looks cohesive. And so we have this right here. Now, let's see how this will look if we were to upload it. Okay, so I have this dummy account and we're gonna try to upload this and kind of see how it looks. This is another example of how it looks. So we have my logo right here. We have the power statement right here. And then we have that call to action. So you see how the arrow was down here at first. I would recommend maybe adding an arrow over here, or just not having an arrow at all. And so we're going to go ahead and we're going to do this one. So let's customize the channel. Then we're going to press change here. Okay, here we go. When you hover over here, this is everything that you will see on desktop. This is everything that you'll see on all devices. Okay, so if this is on all devices, maybe I don't want that arrow there because it doesn't make sense if someone's on mobile and then this part is visible up on TV. Okay, and so let's go ahead and press done. Let's publish and then view it. All right, here we are. Okay, so we have my logo here, a picture of me, my power statement, my arrow pointing to this link here, grab your free guide. We can do without the arrow and we could just kind of just have it hang out there with grab your free guide as the call to action here, okay? This will also enable people to not only subscribe to your channel, but they also will be inclined to join your email list. So that is the goal of this whole thing, okay? Creating something that is going to make it easy for people to subscribe and add to your email list. And that is all that I have for you now. Hopefully this video was not too long. It answered your question. It kind of showed you what to do. I gave you a few options to help you get started, either using the Canva templates and then also using the 90-minute quick start guide to get all the things that you need in order to really make a high converting channel banner. All right. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in the next video.